Welcome to the Knox video training series. In this video, we'll show you how to use the remote support tool in Knox Manage to troubleshoot and control company devices remotely. Let's get started. Knox Manage's web-based remote support viewer can run on any operating system, letting you troubleshoot stress-free. Before you begin, you'll need to create a Samsung account at samsungknox.com. Register for Knox Manage. Add devices to your Knox Manage admin portal, and prepare a PC that runs supported browsers such as Chrome or Firefox. After setting up your Knox Manage account, go to your samsungknox.com dashboard and launch the Knox Manage admin portal. The Knox Manage remote support tool consists of two parts: the remote support app for the user's device and the in-console viewer for IT admins. To receive quick remote support from IT admins, the remote support app should first be installed on each device. We'll show you step by step how to prepare and assign the remote support app to your devices. In the left sidebar of your Knox Manage console, click Application. On the application screen, click Add. You can either add the remote support app as an internal application, or you can assign it through Managed Google Play. In this video, we'll show you how to assign the app through Managed Google Play. On the Select Application Type screen, select Public App, then click OK. On the Add Application screen, make sure Managed Google Play is selected as the store. Then, search for Remote Support for Knox Manage and click on the app in the results. Click Approve, then click Approve again. Finally, click Done. Modify the information as necessary, then click Save and Assign to push the app to your devices. After you've pushed the remote support app to your devices, you're now ready to use the remote support tool. We'll start by showing you how to access the web-based remote support viewer. From your Knox Manage admin portal, navigate to the Device tab, where you can initiate the remote support session on the device. You'll see the device list. Make sure that the device is not in an unenrolled status, otherwise it can't receive remote support. Select the device you want to connect to. In the top menu that appears, click on the Remote Support button. In the pop-up that shows, select Web Viewer as the viewer type. You have two options for run type. If you select Allowed by User, the user must first grant you permission to control the device. If you select Force Run, you can bypass the permissions to run remote support directly. In this example, we'll use Force Run in this video. Select Force Run, then click Run. Once the user agrees to the terms and conditions, the remote support app connects to the remote support viewer. The user's device screen then shows in the remote support viewer. A Knox Manage remote support tab opens, which you can control the target device through. A session summary appears in your Knox Manage admin portal, which displays information on the access code and the duration of the connection. While the connection is set up, the user sees notifications about your actions on the device. All actions are clearly shown, and they can stop the connection anytime. Now we're ready to start troubleshooting remotely. The remote support tool supports various features such as file sharing, screen sharing and capture, video recording, unattended access, and logging of connection time. All these features are available for the Android OS. If you're using a Samsung device or a KPE Knox Suite license, then you can leverage even more features. You can control the device's hardware buttons and use swipe actions on the device screen. These features are also available in the work profile. In this video, we'll demonstrate file sharing, which allows you to remotely download a file from a device. You can use the remote support tool to collect log files from a device and troubleshoot it remotely. Note that this device feature only works for Samsung devices. To start the log collection utility, launch the dialer app and enter *#9900#. Changing the log collection level to high always results in a reboot of the device. At this point, the device restarts and our connection is broken. Restarting the device itself will take a while. In the right corner, you can see an image recorded with a different camera. For the purposes of this video, we have sped up the restart time considerably. Once the device has rebooted, we connect to it using the remote support force run. We return to the dialer and run the log collection console. Type *#9900#. Go to the Run Dumpstate Logcat menu and start collecting logs on the device. Collecting logs takes a while. In this video, we have sped up the time. A log report has been generated on our device. Now we need to copy them to memory. Go to Copy to SD card menu and click on it. We again wait a while for the report to be copied. In the remote support portal, go to the file browser icon. The first click will bring up a window on the device asking for permission to remotely access files on the device. When the user accepts this, a second click on the file browser icon launches a dedicated file manager. Let's go to the log folder. In the folder, we find a file starting with the name Dumpstate and select it. Then click on the File Transfer button in the top right corner. It will start downloading the file to your computer. Report copied. Now we can download it to our computer. The downloaded file will be available on your computer in the download. To end the remote support session, click the Disconnect button. The user can also stop remote support by tapping End on the device screen. You can reconnect to the device if needed, or you can exit by clicking X in the upper right corner of the remote support viewer. The Knox Managed Remote Support tool is a powerful addition to your IT support workflow. What's better is that it's available to Knox Managed customers for free. This concludes our demo on how to use the remote support tool in Knox Manage. For more information on other Knox products, check out docs.samsungknox.com. Thanks for watching.